morning and welcome to our midweek edition of Good Morning North Coast. I am Zoe Sturgeon. I will be your anchor for this show. We are coming to you from the beautiful La Mentone Resort based here in Ballito. Just a quick thank you to the Hair Shack, Perza Water and La Mentone for being our morning show sponsors. So grab your coffee, stay tuned for the weather and surf report. Good morning and welcome to your weather for today, brought to you by Victory Surf. Today will be breezy in the morning, otherwise some sun turning cloudy with a high of 22 degrees and a low of 14 degrees. The real feel will be 21 degrees and the real feel shade 21. We have a north-northeasterly wind at 17 kilometers per hour and wind gusts at 30 kilometers per hour. The sunrise will be at 6:49 a.m. and the sunset at 5:04 p.m. Also, 25% chance of showers today. Joburg, a shower in places in the morning, otherwise breezy with cloudiness, with a high of 16 degrees and a low of 6 degrees. Pretoria, breezy in the morning with a little rain, otherwise mostly cloudy, with a high of 18 degrees and a low of 8 degrees. And then Cape Town, partly sunny with a high of 20 degrees and a low of 14 degrees. Next up will be your surf report, brought to you by Dion Bosman.
Good morning, Ballito, and welcome to Wednesday morning's beach report. And a typical late June morning with light northwesterly breezes till about 10 o'clock this morning, and then we're going to have that big easterly is going to start coming through as the kite season approaches, and all the kite boarders will be out at Tiffany's Reef this afternoon, that's for sure. 17 to 25 knots predicted and a strong northeasterly which will chop the ocean up completely. So get in the water this morning early. I know the tide's a little bit full, but still some good waves around at the bog and at the main beach with some sizable swell around 3-4 feet and some 5-foot sets. Enjoy your morning. Get in there early, guys. It's going to get windy later.
We're on the couch this morning with Tony, talking daily inspiration. Welcome, Tony. It's lovely to have you again.
Yes, Lindy. Thank you. And welcome to you as well. Good to see a new face on set.
Lovely.
Yeah, I want to talk about unlearning.
Okay.
It's a very unusual topic, and it's not something that we're so accustomed to.
Yes.
You know, throughout life, we've been told on numerous occasions, you've got to learn your stuff and know your stuff. And that's what we become, just regurgitated.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, we pick up the information, we learn it for an examination, we cough it out in the papers, exam papers, and that's it, you know. But how much of that information we've actually stored, and it's just accumulating dust. And where's the space for new stuff? That's one of the problems we have. The other challenge we have in life is that we're constantly learning throughout the years of tertiary education and primary education, interacting with our religious leaders, interacting with political organizations and social. All of this is giving us information. So all the time that we're awake, we're actually accumulating information. The idea or the trend these days is not to learn, but to unlearn.
Okay.
Right. And that is what the focus I want to just share with the viewers this morning.
Okay.
Is to get into the mode of understanding what this unlearning is all about. Now, a simple illustration is if you take a cupboard that you've set for storage.
Sure.
And you've had all your stuff in there, you know, your hard drives and all those disks that we had for years and all that. And you're looking for something that you know is somewhere there. You've got to pull all the stuff out before you get there.
Exactly.
Right. Yeah. So the idea is, or the thought behind it is that, do we need all of the stuff? And we got to search very, very carefully. We got to look carefully into our daily living and understand that we don't need all of this stuff all the time.
Okay.
What has happened, Lindy, is also based on other people's opinions, other people's views, other people's perspective of things, we've formed our own foundation.
Sure.
But the true question is that our foundation or is it based on someone else's opinion? So today I want to encourage the viewers to start building on their own foundation.
Okay.
Right? And one of the ways of actually doing it is to make a concerted and committed decision to take stock.
Okay.
Right? Take stock of the stuff you've had. Do a bit of cluttering, decluttering all
your
the
mind.
Time.
Yeah.
Mind decluttering.
Okay.
So it is more about unlearning. And how do we go about doing that is to develop an open mind.
Okay.
Right?
Yes.
When we're sitting around the table and having a meal, or when we're sitting around with people and having a meeting, be bold enough and strong enough to view your views. To bring it out and say, listen, I disagree. This is what I want to bring to the table. Mm. And make it known that you bring it out because you fervently believe that that is what you understand and you think it's a strong point. Very often they say, go with the flow. And I say, why go with the flow?
Yeah.
You know, you need to stop somewhere and be rescued from this flow that's taking you down into nowhere.
Sure.
So that's very important to understand that you can actually stop the process of just learning and develop the process of unlearning while you're going through all of this.
Yeah.
So the idea is to learn, unlearn, learn, unlearn.
Constantly learning and unlearning.
Yes, it's a constant process. There's never an end to that. We give credit to all the university professors and our school teachers and all the people we've interacted with.
Yes.
They've actually helped us to grow to who we are. But are we really who we are?
So how does a person know when is the right time to unlearn?
The right time is right now.
Okay.
Right? You've got to start now. You know, you're a teenager, you've accumulated so much of information.
Yes.
By the time you get to an adult, you're already accumulating more, and we're doing that every day.
Yeah.
So the idea is to do it right now. When a baby is born, up until the age of six or seven years, there's no conscious mind that's developed. It's only the subconscious mind. Mm-hmm. And that's happened to all of us. So by the age of seven, we've accumulated so much of stuff already. Yeah. And that is also not serving a purpose.
Okay.
Right? So we now need to do a lot of decluttering and understand that that's it's possible by making a decision that you want to become open-minded and open ears about what is people saying to you and what are you able to offer in return.
Okay.
Right? And the other idea is to share that with people.
Sure.
Let you become the building blocks of someone else's future. Right? Because you've developed an open mind. And you've developed this open way of looking at things very differently. Mm. And it also helps you to change your perspective of things.
Correct.
You know, when you change the way you see things, things start to change.
Definitely, definitely.
You know, and that's important. We can't just continue going with the flow and thinking that all of that, we're ending up with migraines more than we ever bargained for.
I mean, to someone who's inundated with information, we live in a society that's inundated with social media, everything is just in our face every day.
Yeah.
You never get the time to switch off.
Yeah.
How do you declutter? How do you even get to saying?
By just saying we don't get time to declutter is already a problem.
Okay.
We've got to make that time.
Sure.
Right? And I'm glad that you asked this question because what I have is I have a premium hour. So I get up 1 hour earlier than normal.
Yes.
Right? So if I'm starting my day at 6:30, I get up at 5:30.
Yeah.
And I call it a premium hour. Robin Sharma talks about it as well too. And in that hour, you start preparing yourself for who you want to be. You know, for those who do the prayer, you're welcome to do.
Correct.
So you do do a bit of exercise, you do reading, you do your meditation, you do your self-focus.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. And you start to understand that this is something that's not really adding value to my life today.
Yes.
And I'm going to need to look at, and you start looking at how you're going to let go of these things.
Okay.
You know, holding on to all of these things that we've learned is not serving a purpose every day.
Yeah.
So the more often we make that time.
Yes.
Lindy, the question is, if we don't make the time, we're going to end up in hospital.
Yeah,
then we're going to have to make the time.
Then you need to make time.
Right? Because you don't want to be there. So even then, to start now. Start to do the decluttering right now. Start to unlearn right now. And eventually, you're going to start, you will obviously lead a life that is so flourishing, so colorful, and so abundant.
Yes.
And you obviously will impact that kind of lifestyle on your children and people that are going to be connecting with you as well.
That's beautiful.
So my topic or my message for today is learn, unlearn, learn, unlearn.
Constantly.
Don't forget to bring the unlearning part into the process as well. And share it with others. Let everyone else become open-minded about it. And the thing about with COVID, lastly, I want to say, we've been into lockdown.
Yes.
And we've been locked down with all the clutter.
Yes.
Time to release.
Time to release.
Permission granted. Time to release.
Definitely. We are releasing and learning a lot of things that we've picked up on the way. I love what you just shared with our viewers. It really speaks to self-love and taking care of
Absolutely.
Yourself.
Absolutely. Yeah. I like that self-love.
Thank you so much, Tony.
Thank you so
that
much
was really inspirational.
Me. Great.
After the break, we're chatting to Neville from Ndlondlo Reptile Park.
Welcome back, everyone. And we are sitting here with Neville from Ndlondlo Reptile Park. Welcome.
Thanks, guys.
How are you?
Hey, I'm good, eh?
Awesome. What have you got for us today?
No, I'm just going to chat a little bit about the weather that we've been having lately. Mm-hmm. It's had a profound effect on the environment as a total.
Okay, yes, it has.
Yeah.
Yes.
We've had a total reptile shutdown. So it's been so cold that even the mating has been put on hold.
Oh, wow.
And so that's a plus for me at the moment because I've got a lot of work at the park that I'm busy with.
Yes.
But it's also introduced a new alien invasive species.
Oh.
Yeah. I opened my front door and there was what I thought was a Labrador or golden retriever.
Something big.
And when I had a closer look, it was a polar bear. No.
When do we get polar bears here, Neville?
Since it got this cold.
Something large. Well, I'm expecting, we've gotten to the point where we can expect anything.
Anything.
And I'm just not going to be surprised if we do get polar bears rolling through Belito.
Yeah, or polar bears or penguins or something, you know. But yeah, it's happening, yeah.
Oh my goodness. Insane. But I can imagine, and I didn't think about it before, that all the rain and the floods, I mean, we had two floods. That must have had quite an impact on the reptiles within the area.
It had a huge impact. We had frenetic activity after that as everything being unhoused and dislocated and relocated and moved and so on. So that had an effect. But what it's also done is it saturated the ground.
Okay.
So now when it gets cold, it gets cold.
Yes.
And so the ground activity is slowed down.
Okay.
A crawl.
Yeah, okay. So the reptiles don't like the cold.
They don't like the cold.
Okay.
But in the meantime, we've got a lot of things that we can chat about that is interesting for people to understand. And
okay.
And I picked this up during one of my tours, in fact, day before yesterday, on Saturday.
Okay.
Where somebody had so many questions about spitting snakes.
Oh, yes.
Then I thought, I think it's time we just address this and understand. So the public can understand what a spitting snake is all about.
Mm.
Now, our spitter that we get here is a Mozambique spitting cobra. And it's called a Mozambique spitting cobra not because he comes from Mozambique. He's not an illegal immigrant. Okay? His distribution sort of starts middle Transkei, so around about Mthatha. And then he goes northwards and right up into Tanzania even.
Oh!
So quite a wide distribution.
Yes.
And he's called the Mozambique spitting cobra because he was first described from the port of Maputo, okay, which was then Lorenzo Marx, which was Mozambique.
Yes.
And so, hence the name.
Hence the name, yes.
But spitting is not like people think. You know? That's not what spitting is. It should be spraying.
Yes, the name is a bit misleading, isn't it?
It's a bit misleading. So what you have, cobras are elapids, they're fixed front fanged snakes like mambas. Mm. And if my hand represents the top jaw, fang permanently erect in that position.
Sure.
Now with most elapids, the venom spray is downwards. But the Mozambique spitting cobra has got a target that sits over there somewhere. Mm. And so what this dude did was he gave it a lot of thought. And he went to the local engineering shop in Stanger. And he saw that the foreman looked like a guy who would grab any bit of bucks that he can. And he said to him, listen, bud, please, just plug the hole at the bottom for me and drill it in front.
Okay.
So that my venom's going to spray the same direction as what my eyes are looking.
Yes.
And this shifty bugger did it.
They like evolved in
a
way.
So the hole is now pointing forward. There's a 90 degree venom direction change.
Very strange.
Line of vision is parallel to the exit of the venom.
Sure,
that makes them extremely accurate.
Makes them very dangerous, even more so than other spitting snakes? Spraying snakes.
Even though the guy is, all the cobras are on a par. All the spitting cobras are on a par. But it's not only cobras that spit or spray.
Okay. Yes, yes.
So in South Africa, we've got the rinkles as well. The rinkles is not found down here by us. It doesn't get cold enough here. However, lately I'm wondering.
Yes,
anyway,
that might change.
Anyway, so wrinkles are more a half-shelled snake. They like colder and cooler climates where the winters at least get cold. They don't mind warm summers. They want cold winters.
Okay.
And they haven't evolved as fully as the Mozambique spinning cobras in that even though they've got a slight direction change, it's like a 15-degree direction change.
But and not as extreme.
Not as extreme. So their whole spitting tactic is to get up, face the target like that, and then they throw themselves forward, and at the same time, the head sort of, the nose rides up.
To get the angle.
Fangs point roughly in the direction of the target.
Wow.
And but the eyes are looking up there, so he's got no way of telling whether it's accurate or not.
Okay, so that and would so kind of affect...
Can't affect it. You see, their technique is designed for smaller animals like meerkat and mongoose and skunks and stuff like that, which is when he's reared up more or less at eye level.
Yes.
Whereas Mozambique spitting cobras occur in the warmer climates where you've got bigger predators and they now need to be able to get up like
they've
that.
Evolved to be able to do that, which is insane, the way these things work.
Absolutely.
Incredible.
Yeah, incredible.
That's insane. Because I think so many of us just see anything that spits as terrifying.
Yeah.
But when you get to know it, it's like fascinating.
Yeah, I've often told people that a Mozambique spitting cobra commands almost more respect than a mamba because he can get you from 2.5 meters away, you know.
So move far away at the other direction and call you.
The luck of it is that spitting is just a defense thing. And the objective is to simply blind you, distract you, and allow him the route to escape without you seeing where he's going.
Okay.
So it's not a matter of he's spraying venom in your eyes and then he's going to come and bite you.
Okay. I mean, of course, the venom can blind you, though, I assume.
Yeah, if you don't rinse it out.
Okay.
But I promise you, if you get that venom in your eyes, you want to rinse it out. Very quickly.
I can imagine. We had some close calls growing up on the farm. Oh. We had many close calls where I think my mom managed to get bitten sprayed right on the corner of her eye.
But no.
It wasn't that accurate, thank goodness.
No.
Otherwise, it was very scary. But we grew up walking around corners and there's another snake. It's just like, another day in farm life, I suppose.
particularly in subtropical KZN, eh?
Mm. Yes. Definitely, 100%. That's fantastic and so fascinating. Absolutely love it. We always have such interesting conversations. And it's nice that the more we talk about these things, the more I'm educated. I think there's less fear for people.
Yeah, bigger understanding reduces the fear.
Yes, because if we know how to handle these situations, we're less likely to go on the defense of ourselves, which isn't healthy for the snakes, of course.
Well, not healthy for people either.
Yeah, it's not healthy for anyone. That's phenomenal. Thank you so much for coming in, as always, though, Neville. Absolutely phenomenal to have you here. And as usual, we will be seeing you soon.
Mm-hmm.
And awesome that you're here. Absolutely fascinating. And y'all, you heard it. Educate yourselves, and we don't have to be as scared. But please, stick around. We will be back right after this ad break.
We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone, and on we roll with the show. We are sitting down to talk about the Miss Bolito cocktail event that is coming up. Welcome, Heidi.
Hi, Zoe. It's so great to be here this
awesome.
Morning.
Awesome. So happy to have you. So tell me, this year's Miss Bolito. I mean, it's quite an involved event. I feel like a lot goes into it. How are we doing so far on that?
Yeah, there's quite a lot happening, and I think the girls have been extremely busy this year at all sorts of events, which has been amazing. But yeah, we've got our cocktail evening coming up on Thursday night at CMH, Motor City Bolito. They are also our main sponsor this year, which has been so amazing.
Awesome.
It's big, bold, and brave. Okay. 200 rand a ticket, which includes a welcome drink and some food. And then you will get to meet some of the finalists, well, all of the finalists, and also their sponsors. They will be introducing themselves and their sponsors to the community.
Okay, phenomenal. And do you find that all the girls have settled in so far?
Yes, I think they've made some amazing friendships. They're going good, but there are still one or two girls that are in need of a sponsor.
Okay.
So if there are any businesses out there that are still willing to sponsor one of our finalists, please, would be really, really
and
awesome.
And any business in the area?
Any business, even an individual person if they would like to.
And in case they're curious, what goes into the process of sponsoring one of the girls?
It's a 5,000 rand sponsorship, which gives you tickets to the cocktail evening and to the crowning evening. And then also advertising on our social media pages. And obviously also the finalists will be available to you to promote your business during their time until the 1st of September.
Yes, I mean, the event is always very well publicized, so it would be a good move for any local business.
And obviously you get to introduce yourself as well at the cocktail and the crowning evening, yes.
Oh, that's phenomenal. Absolutely love it. That's so exciting. And for people that want to get involved, whether it be sponsors and even just going to get tickets to view your cocktail evening, how can they get involved in that?
Either on our social media platforms, so Facebook or Instagram, or they can email us on missbolito.rotaryzimbali@gmail.com.
That's so exciting. That's awesome. And so this is the cocktail event. What happens after that?
After that, they still have to do a charity project. And we've also got a weekend away on the Shaya Manzi, which is really exciting.
Awesome.
And then we've got the crowning evening on the 1st of September, which will be at Kolishin Estate.
Awesome.
A really glitzy, very formal black tie event.
Oh, that's so exciting. Yes. It's so exciting that we have that happening here in Bolito.
Yes.
It's awesome. And I think it gives a lot of our young ladies such an excuse to do these things. They learn so much from it, and to do some good deeds with charity.
And it also gives the community a chance to dress up a little and have a bit of fun after everything.
Have a good night out. Get dressed up. It's definitely what we need at the moment, is to pull out those dresses that got locked away like early 2020. They're all sitting gathering dust. And those favorite heels that are still sitting in the cupboard, not being worn.
Yeah.
That's so exciting. Thank you for being here, of course. We look forward to having you back very soon to hear more about the progress that you're having. And I'm sure you guys are absolutely on crunch at the moment, working very hard. So I really wish you luck on that. And I hope everything goes smoothly for you guys.
Thank you very much. And I hope to see all of you on Thursday night.
Yes, awesome. Well, you guys heard it. Get yourselves there. It is going to be epic. It's going to be so much fun. Get yourselves involved. But please hang around. We will be back right after the ad break.
Thank you. I'm Tanya. I'm the lady from So It Seems, Benina, in Belito. You can find us in Richard Park, right across from the Hirsch. The new shop. It's 3 times bigger than the old shop. We have lots more fabric, a lot more haberdashery items. If you can't sew, I will teach you how to sew. I have an additional teacher that helps us sew, and we have a fabulous space upstairs. Looking for a Benina machine or a Benet? I will sort you out with that one. In this little area, we do everything. We service the sewing machine, we service the overlocker. We fix it up for you. Within a week, you'll have it back. While you go through the pattern books, we have a coffee shop in-house called Buttonless Coffee. You can have a coffee or a snack to eat while you do your pattern searching, fabric searching, or sewing upstairs with us. See you soon.
Everyone, and we are sitting with our own Dominic from La Montagne, and I believe we have something exciting to discuss this morning.
Indeed we do, yes. So obviously on Thursday, on Youth Day, those of the people who follow us on our social media pages would know that Thursday on Youth Day, we launched our new kiddies playground. We refer to it as Fred's Deck, because Fred is our mascot here at La Montagne, who entertains the kids and that. It was quite a success, I find. Even though it was quite chilly, there was quite a lot of kids running around. Plus we had Hannah B singing her songs, which was very lovely as well. And yeah.
Well, I can attest to the fact that it was a successful day spent, having been here myself. And I love the morning routine with Fred out there dancing with the staff. Yes. And it just sets the vibe for the day, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. Yeah, yeah. He does that every day. 10 a.m. on routine, they do their dance, get the energy up. Yeah,
yes.
It's very nice. Yeah,
and I
yeah.
saw one of our very own ones, the one of the director's little ones, Grayson, was like right stuck in the middle, and I think he's almost learning the routine off by heart by this point.
Yeah, I saw him as well, jamming in between them there. Yeah.
And I think the kids absolutely love it.
Yeah, they did, yeah, yeah.
That's awesome.
So, yeah.
Awesome. And just about the playground itself, I mean, I did see that, I mean, the event went so well with all the live entertainment and everything involved in that.
Yeah.
But, I mean, as a parent, every time we go out somewhere, it's always such a big deal to me to make sure, have they got somewhere safe to play? And is there childminders, that
yes,
kind of
so
thing?
So unfortunately, on Youth Day itself, we didn't have childminders in. We thought we'll first see how it does go. And obviously, from it being such a success, we have now decided that we will get in childminders. It's probably only going to be on a Saturday and Sunday for now.
Yes,
and
of
obviously,
course.
Public holidays or so as well. We'll get in childminders that can look after the kids while the parents then relax, have a cocktail,
yes.
have something to eat, enjoy
That's
their time.
Great.
Yeah, instead of the parents always jumping up and running
yes.
after their kids. Yeah.
Well, that is the problem. I mean, we do spend, like, there can be a jungle gym, but my littlest one is 2 years old.
Yeah.
So for him to be scaling a jungle gym on his own, I mean, he's such a brave little thing that he would, but it's scary, and you need an adult to step in and catch them.
Yeah, exactly. But I must say one point, though, that we did go with is the AstroTurf that is under the jungle gym, so that if a kid does fall, it does actually have a soft sponge.
Soft landing, yes.
Yeah, so it's not like landing on concrete or anything
yes.
like that.
Yes, okay, so we shan't have any hospital trips.
Yeah, no, hopefully not.
This is phenomenal and great news. As a parent, I'm like super stoked. Because
yes.
when I saw it set up, I remember saying, I think I spoke to you about it, saying, this is so awesome. To have a place to go and have lunch and have somewhere safe for the kids to play, you know
exactly.
that someone is watching them.
Yeah.
It's just... for parents, especially on the weekend, to actually get a chance to de-stress
exactly,
for like an hour.
Yeah.
And that's like a miniature holiday for us.
Yeah, I know, yes, tell me about it. I've got two myself.
Oh, well, exactly. And it helps that we're sitting in a resort, so we almost get to feel like we're having a little miniature holiday. Right here in our hometown. That's so exciting.
Yeah, fantastic.
Awesome. And I look forward to giving it a try.
Thank you.
So I might actually come in the next, I think this coming weekend. When will your childcarers be there, do you think?
Hopefully by this weekend.
Hopefully
I am on it. So yeah, it's just a matter of getting someone in quickly.
Yeah, well, and someone that you can trust as well.
Yeah, exactly.
It sets parents' minds.
We're not just going to go with anyone. We're going to go with anyone, with someone that has, you know, previous child care experience.
Yes, or, that's also
because, yeah, looking after kids isn't as easy as what it seems. So.
Especially if there's a large group, it can get very overwhelming and you need someone that can handle pressure and it's very good with children and the tantrums and
exactly, that's it, you know, kids.
All the drama.
Yeah,
it's like a miniature little soap opera that can happen up there if you don't have the right person watching them.
Well, actually this Friday, because Hannah B was actually such a, you know, good singer and that, and we saw how the crowds pulled in, that we are actually going to start doing live entertainment now every Friday night. It's probably going to run between 5 till 8 p.m. So this Friday, the 24th, if I'm not mistaken, we're actually having Winston Smile
come in
and sing. Yeah, he's very well known in Belita.
One of our favorites. Very good entertainer.
Yeah, very good entertainer.
One of these artists that doesn't just play well, but also has that entertainment factor.
He gets the crowd involved as well. You know, I've seen him go up with a mic to people and they sing as well. So he gets them all into it. So
it
should be good.
It could be a fun and exciting evening spent.
Yeah, Friday night. Yeah, we'll have some drink promos running, everything.
That's so exciting.
Yeah,
going to be awesome. I absolutely love every time I come here, seeing that there's so many new and exciting things
happening. We want to get Le Menton back to where it used to be.
Yes. That's so exciting. Yeah. I absolutely love it. Thank you so much for coming in, as always. We love having you here.
Thank you.
That's awesome. And we'll see you again soon.
Yeah, definitely.
And I'll hopefully be seeing you very soon as well to take advantage of the child caring in the playground.
Yeah.
Great. Many parents will, I think, definitely.
Exactly, No, cool.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right, well, you guys heard it. For all the parents out there, oh, my great giddy aunt, is this exciting or what? You have beautiful scenery and you have child caring and great food, great company, great music coming up. So come and check us out. We'll be seeing you soon right after this ad break.
Austria Accounting, we are more than chocolate counters.
At Austria Accounting, we specialize in accounting,
taxation,
company secretarial services,
business advisory services, accounting cloud software,
full payroll administration to ensure full compliance.
And we service our clients in English, Afrikaans, and isiZulu.
Don't get caught with your hand in the chocolate jar when we can be your greatest asset.
Structural joints. So before painting a house, you would obviously, you would often look at a house and you would see, paint bubbling and what have you. And normally around there, you see these lines that have been cut into the plaster. So those are joints between different substrates. So about under that, if you chip the plaster off, you'll see a nice concrete beam and then you'll see brickwork. But because they have different densities, they're going to move and they're going to crack. So if we don't cut that line through the plaster, we're going to constantly see this cracker form. Wow. So what the line does is it controls that, it allows for that. And you fill that with a flexible sealer. Over time, that sealer decays and then allows water to get in, which then comes out on the wall below. Wow. So again, you know, who knew until now that that was even a thing, you know? Yes. But it is, it's a big, and it's one of the most common things that we find is that people probably, well, most often don't, they just roll it in, like sort of gently groove it into the plaster, don't actually cut it right through the plaster.
So that you know it's there.
So the joint needs to go right through the plaster because the plaster is the one that's going to be, that's going to crack when the two bits move. And again, because of the environment that we live in, we've got large expansion and contraction due to the humidity and the temperatures.
Right.
This time of year is a biggie because we, you know, not that it's very cold, you know, 19 degrees is just about freezing for us Bellatorians, but yeah, you know, it does get chilly. And then during the day, it gets quite hot. So we do have a lot of movements between the materials that we use to build with.
Yes.
And then carrying on from the structural side of things, we obviously get along the coastal complexes and that sort of thing, a lot of spalling. So people might wonder what spalling is, and the spalling is when you see the plaster on a column or a slab soffit, which is the underside of the slab, cracking and popping off because the steel reinforcing inside is actually rusted. So obviously, we're talking about preventative maintenance. Mm. Once spalling occurs, I think you've probably missed the opportunity. However, there's always an opportunity to save yourself money by acting fast. Okay. When you realize that there's a problem. So spalling is, yes, it has already occurred, but it's an early indicator to like far more severe structural issues if it's not attended to. So a lot of people just think, oh no, we'll pop the plaster off, you know, brush the steel and pop it and then replaster it. However, that doesn't work. Any rust that is on the steel will continue to rust if it is not 100% removed. So you almost need to sandblast that steel down to let it be a toothpick's worth of thickness, you know, to get rid of all the rust. Put a rust converter on, treat it with an oxide and a rust preventative, and then you have to use a structural grout, which is a micro concrete, high MPA, quick drying, and use that to repair, to limit the amount of moisture to, you know, getting back into that area. And also to try and kill any rust that you maybe didn't get to that's still covered by concrete. So spalling is a big one. And we can definitely help you with all of that. You know, a lot of these engineering repairs do require advice from engineers, which we work with a lot as well around town. So lots to think of.
So this preventative maintenance is huge. It's not just your cars and your fridges and microwaves and those sort of things that are hit by rust. It's also your structures. So, you know, I'm sure all of you found this incredibly interesting. And Jason's also going to be sharing some examples with us so that we can physically see for ourselves what to look out for. So make sure that you stay with us while we experience some of Jason's knowledge.
Mandy, you pointed out something very interesting there about servicing your cars. Now, if you think about how people are pedantic about their cars, why would you not be the same about your biggest asset? I mean, it's the thing you spend the most money on a month. It's the thing that you probably put down when you're applying for finance or anything as your, you know, I've got one of these, so you know, give me money. But you don't want to put any money into protecting it. It does seem, you know, that the mindset maybe needs to be adjusted. You know, it's your biggest asset, look after it. And to do that, you partner with someone who can and knows what they're doing. And it's not going to fill you with lies and bullshit and everything else that you can't say on the camera. But.
Well, you know what? Jason is so right. Your home is your most valued item, physical item. And yes, you know, we all used to having rust in fridges and microwaves and things like that down here. And our cars. But your home having rust, I think, is a new topic for a lot of people. And we're going to be showing you examples of what Jason has mentioned already, so that we can be aware of this. So make sure you stay with us, and we're going to be seeing some examples of what Jason's been chatting about.
Coming up on our Chapman Building segment next week, we'll be continuing with today's topic.
You like queuing to pay electricity?
Don't think so. VodaPay.
Wait, so I can use it?
Even if I'm on another network.
VodaPay.
Off to do the monthly
shopping. It's done.
Really?
Yeah, Coco.
And we get rewards.
We like sending and receiving money now.
How about when the combos communicate?
VodaPay.
Introducing VodaPay, the one app for anything and everything. Like it, VodaPay it.
And there you have it, everybody. Thank you to every guest and viewer for making today's show so incredibly special. Good Morning North Coast will close the show with a music video showcasing our very own Hannah B. Enjoy your week and be safe, and we will see you again on Friday morning, 6 a.m.
Shine, it's mine, tell me, creating, liberating, reverberating in this journey called